a little bit better. Don't know. Never know. Never know what's going to work the best till you're doing this. I wanted to just tell you guys that the Holy Spirit gave me a little nugget just as I was driving right now. I don't know where I'm looking at over there. I think I'm looking at over there. You know, a lot of people are questioning why Paula White was put in office, appointed recently by President Trump as the person that basically, I think, is in charge of religion. Hey, Jennifer. So I just thought that I would put this out there for you guys to consider and pray about, because I felt like the Lord definitely, just like when he gives you one of those aha moments and you go, oh, that's why. And so, you know, I saw a video of a male pastor that is a Baptist, I'm pretty sure, you know, and a lot of the pastors, they are all for male, you know, the male people sort of running the show in church and that kind of thing. And they're really not for women pastors, let alone women doing any serious roles in the church. And so this one pastor, who is quite well known, was saying, oh my gosh, doesn't he know that she, Paula White, he was meaning her, is charismatic, Pentecostal, and here he puts her in charge over in Washington to work with him. Well, I have been praying about that for the last couple of days since I heard that and saw that video. And of course, one thing that I know impresses Donald Trump is money. If you are successful financially, that impresses him. That gets his attention. Paula White has accumulated quite a lot of money throughout the years. I don't know how, and I'm not judging her. I'm just saying that we all know she has an apartment, if you want to call it that, in the Trump Towers, and has for many years. She claims to have inside friendship with him, talks to him. I don't know. I'm not judging that. But I will tell you one thing that the Holy Spirit said to me, because this pastor, this male pastor, was very concerned. He said, uh-oh, now here we got a Pentecostal, a charismatic in the White House. What in the world's going to happen now? Well, I'll tell you what the Holy Spirit just told me driving just now. He said to me, I appoint who I want to be in office. And Paula has been appointed this. I'm going to say, I don't know much about Paula right now. I don't follow her ministry. I know that she loves the Lord. She says, I don't know. God only knows. But the Lord showed me. He said, I appoint these people in office. You see, it's not what some church affiliation feels is supposed to be doing this or doing that with government. God has the final say, is what he was showing me. He said, I put her in this position for such a time as this. I hope Paula sees this. That would be fantastic. Not that she doesn't already know this. I'm sure she does. I'm sure God has already told her this. But he said, I have put her in. I have appointed her for such a time as this, because you see, Donald Trump has specific areas that get his attention. And Paula White, I have put in there because I'm going to use her to touch those specific areas within Donald Trump to trigger his faith and many other areas of his life. And so I just wanted to put that out there. I really feel that God has appointed her. It's no coincidence that she is newly appointed in charge of religious affairs or something like that. She's on the paid salary now in the White House, and I'm not judging it. I was praying about it to see, I was thinking about it, because that's a very important position, you know. So I was concerned and I was praying, and I felt like the Lord really just put my mind at ease and said, Susan, it's okay. Don't worry about a thing, because I am in charge of it all, you know. And so maybe it's sort of funny how we see a lot of these male conservative pastors that are just so used to women being in charge. And here we have a president that's hiring a lot of women in office, right? And I mean, look at a lot of them. So it's sort of interesting how God will do what God will do, and no man is going to tell God what to do, and man is not going to run God in the first place. And I'm not saying it is the hour for women to be in charge. I'm not saying anything like that. I'm just simply saying, do you think it's any coincidence that all of a sudden Paula is appointed this after many years of knowing him and also God leading her in this direction to have an apartment in the Trump Towers? That's all I'm saying. I think it's very interesting. I'm going to be watching it, but I am totally at ease with it now. You know, God leads us by the Spirit, and he will reveal anything to each of us if we will just ask him and pray, because he loves us and he wants us to be at ease. He doesn't want us to be worried or confused or, you know, listening to what one big, well-known A-list pastor happens to say about this or that. You just scruff that and ask, go straight to the source. Just go straight to your Father. And so I want to know what you think about that. What do you think about that? How does that register in your spirit? Leave a comment. Let me know. I'm going to be watching for your comment, because it just like set with my spirit. So easy. Not because I'm a woman that happens to be a licensed minister. No. Because there is no gender in the Holy Spirit. We know that. But I think it's really wonderful that our Lord knows how to reach everyone. Amen. All right. I love you. I have to go now, but wanted to just leave that with you and leave me a comment. So I want to see what you got to think about this. Have a blessed day, you guys. Love you a lot. Bye-bye for now.